Brian Clark, why is it that you came out of this game talking to me about your concerns about the Ravens when they got the win and the Eagles are the one everyone is worried about?
Because the Ravens are all Lamar Jackson. And I know that sounds like a good thing when you have a dude on the outside doing the Cupid shuffle and throwing sidearm touchdowns to tight end. And then you can see him break a long one for 50 yards and finish off the game with two good runs. But they have no consistency. They have no identity. And for a team who should have a distinct identity, for a team who should know exactly who they are, they're out searching for other things. Greg Roman is out trying to figure out, how can I make myself more attractive for head coaching jobs by fixing Lamar Jackson? No, you're breaking him. Allow Lamar Jackson to do what he's great at. Allow Lamar Jackson to be the focal point of the offense and build everything around him. Until this offense figures that out, until this team understands who they truly are and stops and regressing as an offense, you can't even count them in the elite of the AFC. If Carson Wentz has anybody to throw to other than myself, Rex Ryan, or Dan Orlowski, they find a way to win that game.
None taken. But Rex, as he was talking, I noticed you were nodding vigorously. You agree.
Yeah, I mean, Ryan is dead on with this. So sometimes I've seen it before. As coordinators, they want to elevate themselves. I'm going to make Lamar Jackson a pocket passer, and, you know, we're going to throw traditional passing game. That's not what you have. Be who you are. Let Lamar be who he is, and don't apologize for winning. Like, you're going to get a head coaching job based on wins, nothing else. You're not a genius. You have a once-in-a-lifetime player, a talent at that position. Just use him.
Meanwhile, Dan, I want to talk to you about Carson Wentz, because
he
brought his team back into this game, and the Eagles are you're right. He's out there literally throwing a ball to guys that we've never heard of.
They had one starter. One starter was on the field, Jason Kelce, at the last half of that game. Zach Ertz got hurt. They had two to start the game. And Carson Wentz won the football game. That game should have been 42-30. Two dropped touchdowns, one early on by Hightower and another by Miles Sanders. But the slump that Carson Wentz was in, America, that you guys all wanted to celebrate because you hate on him, it's over. His last three games have been absolutely outstanding. And I'm just telling you guys, like I told everyone last year, write it down. If the next 2 months he plays like he has the last 3 weeks, the Eagles somehow will win the division. They might win it at 5-10-1. I don't care. But he is again proving to you that he is one of the better young quarterbacks in football. And let them get these next three, because I think they're next three against the NFC East.
Yeah.
They will be in first place. The slump is over. You can't celebrate anymore.
They have Giants, Washington Giants starting this Thursday. RC, 15 seconds, go.
Dan, nobody's hating on Carson Wentz. Carson Wentz was playing bad. Now he has his groove again. The thing is, I agree with you that they should win it, but let's not start feeling this way about Carson Wentz when we watch Dak Prescott play from behind in a lot of games and put up great numbers. These things have to start turning into wins for Carson Wentz to truly be out of his slump.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.